Kelly Loeffler has a lot to answer for. Really, the only person who comes close is also running in one of the runoffs, and that is Purdue, who we'll turn to. But the fact that Kelly Loeffler has apparently been cleared on all the stock trading and buying that she did with secret information, that she should not have any public position ever for the rest of her life. And apparently she's gonna be cleared. Warnock at least is trying to make it a campaign issue. So here they are with that back and forth.
Loeffler, when you receive the private briefing regarding the coronavirus pandemic, you dumped millions of dollars of stock in order to protect your own investments. And then weeks later, when there came an opportunity to give ordinary Georgians an extra $600 of relief, you said you saw no need and called it counterproductive. Why do you think it's counterproductive to help ordinary Georgians in the middle of a pandemic?
Well, thank you for that question, because I've been completely exonerated. Those are lies perpetrated by the left-wing media and Democrats to distract from their radical agenda. Since I got to the Senate, I've worked hard to deliver relief to Georgians during this pandemic, and I'm continuing to do that.
Okay, so while he was talking, I get why Manny Fidel was able to get those screenshots, because she just had that same dead-eyed thousand-yard stare that only a billionaire who knows everything's gonna be okay could possibly have. But he was right. She opposed aid, still isn't, like, she's a senator. She could be pushing for it right now if she actually cared whether the people of Georgia live or die, but she doesn't, because they are peasants and she doesn't care about them. All she cared about was protecting her own interests. The fact that she could get this private briefing and then go and sell off stock and then buy stock in companies that would benefit during a pandemic and then go and tell the American people everything's gonna be fine, don't worry about it. Like, I would say if she could get reelected, it will be evidence that American democracy fundamentally doesn't work if you can do all that and get elected. But it doesn't even matter. It's already broken. None of it works. Like, she can't even hide behind charisma, honestly. No. She is so obviously corrupt, obviously explicitly corrupt. And she's exonerated, but that is an indictment of the system. That's all it is. It should be illegal. It's not. That doesn't make it right. It doesn't make it moral just because the system has been set up by corrupt people like Kelly Loeffler. She's not the only one. What the others came before her and set up a system where they could corruptly benefit themselves financially. She thinks that that's a defense. It's on Warnock to make sure that the people understand that that is not a defense in any way. Lay out what she did. No regular person thinks that that's acceptable. Nobody actually thinks that that's cool that a billionaire gets to do that during a pandemic where they're like suffering and dying and losing their jobs.
Absolutely. And this is what we know now. I mean, pull the string and think about any, I don't know, company she's invested in that got PPP loans. We know that that's been going around a lot. You know, Trump, Kushner, their real estate properties have gotten PPP loans, protected like no jobs because of it. Yeah. We're not done here. Like, this, it's such an important example of the way the 1% does not care about whether we live or die at all. They physically and economically, they don't care. And so look, Loeffler, man, she may win. She may very well win, because like John mentioned, there are millions of dollars in ads that are streaming into, you know, the only place that people are right now, which is their homes mostly. Yeah. But that being said, there are grassroots organizations, and Georgia did turn blue, all right? You guys, there is a sea change there. And there are grassroots organizations who've been building in the communities that have felt completely iced out because they only see someone like Loeffler. And you know, and Warnock, let's give him credit, is coming at this and not saying, well, I'm not gonna touch that because it's, you know, I don't wanna play dirty politics. He's going right to it. Mm-hmm. He is mentioning it because, as he should, this is what the Republicans represent and what he represents. And what he's saying is, I want there to be relief, economic relief for people. So I think we need to not forget what Warnock is offering in this moment, and the fact that he is a more progressive Democrat, that he is African American, that he is running a grassroots campaign. And man, I really hope that that shows and paves the way for Democrats, that you got this, you know, Wall Street Barbie who should be so easy to beat. And Warnock is giving, I mean, the polling is close. Warnock is giving her a run for her money.
Yeah. Yeah, and look, Warnock is not everything that we would obviously want in a candidate, but Kelly Loeffler is just They took a sack, they filled it up with corruption and billions of dollars, and that's all it is. It's like, it should be the most obvious example, I think, in an election that I can remember, other than possibly Donald Trump. And he's been able to sort of hide behind this fake populism. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.